What's up, adventurers? Today I want to talk about something that was circulating around Child being able to hit in the 300,000s for damage, as posted by somebody named Psyox, and I'm going to leave the video in the description so you can check it out for yourself, but I wanted to explain the breakdown as to how this is happening, what mechanics are being used to do this. Now, my video yesterday on the new weapons being busted is also going to come into play with this concept, so please keep in mind that what's going on with Child is just the beginning. I'm pretty confident about that just based on the facts. You know, we've got shield characters were introduced earlier than any builds that could maximize their performance, right? So we had Noelle, we have Diana, and there's no bows that benefit from shields. And in the next banner, we're going to have two units that create shields, Xinyan, a Pyro Claymore carry, and Zhongli, a Geo Polam support. Both of them can create shields, and both the weapons offered in the next banner are released by MiHoYo inside of the events section, briefly describing that shields boosting the attack percentage scaling. We know that the meta is going to be going in that direction. Now, Zax also realized this and started doing some testing on his own, and I'm also really glad he did. He has these characters, he's got some of them built. He deserves a kudos for sharing this, so thank you so much for doing that, man. Let's go ahead though and walk through how this is happening, okay? Now, the units that are being primarily used is going to be Child, Bennett, Noelle, and some other form of support. And it's you're gonna want Animo, and for a very particular reason. Now, starting off, we have Child built with a crit build. And the reason you need crit is just because of how his kit works. Then you're gonna also need Retracing Bolide, which is an artifact set that was just introduced with this. And it is right here, the Domain of Goyun. On 4-piece, while protected by a shield, gains an additional 40% normal and charge attack damage, plus it increases the shield strength. This is extremely crucial to this build. We have Bennett on Noblesse Oblige. The reason for that is because you want to increase the elemental burst damage, because that's he does really well with that, from my understanding. I've never built him, but from what I've heard, he's pretty broken when it comes to that. Using an elemental burst increases all party members' attack by 20%, so that's kind of the goal. Then you also have Noelle, 4-piece. Upon obtaining an elemental shard created through a crystallized reaction, all party members gain a 35% damage bonus for this particular element for 10 seconds. So this one's a little bit shorter than the artifact set for Bennett. Venti is going to be the Animo support in this case. And Viridescent Venerer is the artifact set that makes Animo characters pretty overpowered as a support. When you use the swirl effect with another element, it decreases opponent's elemental resistance to the element infused in the swirl by 40%. So Child is built based on hydro damage, and you can see that because when you ascend him, that's when he gets boosted as a passive. So, and if you have these artifacts built in the right way, you know, you got crit rate, you got hydro damage plus and crit damage, then you're gonna be able to maximize this performance significantly. But I'm just putting it here so you can see it, but I haven't built this, but there's already proof of that, so we don't even need to talk about that piece. And then for Bennett, you're gonna be basically, he's energy recharge as a passive, and you want to basically maximize energy recharge, elemental mastery. His constellation is nuts, because on the first one, he no longer has an HP restriction to increase the attack percentage, and he gains an additional 20% of his base attack. And then when Bennett's HP falls below 70%, he gets more energy recharge. Let me just kind of show you exactly what this does, just because some people may not know. If the health of a character within the AoE that he creates is equal to or falls below 70%, their health will continuously regenerate. The amount of HP restored scales off Bennett's max HP. If the health of the character within the AoE is higher than 70%, they're going to gain an attack bonus that is based on Bennett's base attack. Look here. That attack bonus ratio is 56% at base. I'm sure it scales up as you level it up. That's a pretty significant increase in itself. So you do get an additional elemental damage using someone like Ventir as a support, and I think most of the Animo characters have that as well. I'm not going to check it, but that's something you can check for yourself. So it's going to increase the Hydro damage if I pair it with Hydro. Now, where this makes it extremely broken is if you look at Child or Tartaglia. If you look at his burst ability at base, has a 464% scaling when you're in a melee stance. And when you level this up to level 7, I want to say Zyx showed it, it's like 694%. So it's insane, almost 700%. He was comparing it to Diluc, which is Diluc's only scales to 300%. So this scaling also makes this extremely plausible. Now, my units are scaled at a very low level, so I'm using Tartaglia at 70, Bennett at level 20, Noelle at level 20, and Venti at level 70 for this. And I put very low level gear on them, like Bennett's using a 22 Skyward Sword, Noelle is using a 20 Bell, Venti is using a 40 or 50 Favonius Warbow, and Child is the only one that actually has the Skyward Harp, which is at like 60 right now. So just to kind of give you an idea of what I'm using, that's how I'm doing some smaller scaling damage with this currently. Child is really the only one dealing any kind of damage. So as I'm showcasing this here, you're going to go from using Child's aim shot to cause Riptide to then switch to Venti to use the burst ability, and then you are going to switch to Bennett to use the Q ability or burst ability, and then you are going to switch to Noelle to use her shield, and then you're going to switch to Child to use his melee stance skill ability. That's where you're getting all of the damage output from. It's only showing 8,000 now because I do not have Bennett built. I don't have Child fully built. They're all at base level stats for their abilities, so the scaling is not increased, and all the artifacts are still really low level as well. So we would need to build those in order to get anywhere with this and show the true ability. But if you do want to see it again, please check out Xiox's video. I'll go ahead and link it in the description once again, just so you can see what it can do if you do build it. This is the strategy behind it, right? Child is being used because of his burst scaling. So his burst scaling being 464%, imagine that this is 700%. That's an extra 300% on that already once that's leveled for the example that Xiox is using. Alongside with all of these are also level 7 for him as well. But I can see these numbers being dropped by Beidou, Xinyan, Zhongli, Ningwang if done correctly. Now this does break the game in a way that needs to be addressed, and I'm sure miHoYo is probably seeing this. They're probably going to scale it back just because of how busted it is. So before you dump all your resources on it, I'd recommend holding back and waiting to see if they respond to it, because as we've seen, they're very active in the community when people bring these things and throw them in their face. If something's thrown off balance, they do not like that. So just to recap, right now the unit pairings are busted because of the mechanics for shields. You can build them if you'd like to try them, the combinations out with different units in their place, but these are the ones used based on their scaling, bonuses put together, maximizing their output currently. This is a good time to subscribe because I am going to go full time on Genshin content for my channel. My goal is to break the game's mechanics down in a way that understand concepts so you can build the best teams and focus on enjoying the adventure of this beautiful game. Consider subscribing or liking this if it helped you out. You don't have to, but I just want to throw that out there. Feel free to join the Discord and reach out to me anytime. I try to respond to all the comments in all my previous videos. Y'all gave me a challenge with that, but I definitely try my best to respond to everybody, and I want to thank you for all your support for my small channel. It's grown quickly compared to what I thought, so I just wanted to say thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next one.